Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're out of Westport, Washington, trolling deep with herring for Chinook salmon with John Keizer of Salt Patrol. Now if you want to learn how to catch more salmon, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. Got a good early start on a late August morning in the midst of the best Central Washington salmon season in recent memory.
We just pulled out of the Westport Marina and we're headed out into the ocean here. We're about to enter what's called the Grace Harbor Bar. So it'll be just a little choppy. We got a little bit of a tide running this morning. So once we get out in the ocean, it should be a pretty good day out there. Once you can see a little bit, going to be dealing with a little bit of fog here. But as you can see, we're just kind of navigating by electronics and kind of work our way out there. Looks like fishing should be good.
So we just ran out, guys. We're about 18 miles straight west of Westport, just about out. This is kind of where they've been catching them. Last week we were inshore. This week fish moved out, so we're fishing a little bit deeper. We're about 300 feet of water.
This is the back rod, and we're putting out a diver. So basically it's a deep six with the release on it and a fish flash. And we're going to go down to a herring cured in Pro Cure. Right in bite. And we're just gonna run that shallow. The other ones we're running deep. But I'll go ahead and put a little bit of this on here. Get a little extra scent. Like bloody tuna. I just put some gel in there. Give it just a little bit more. Tie it like a little, you look here, there's a little piece of yarn up in there. Tie it on there. Makes it great for holding that scent in there. Give it a good shot. It works pretty good.
Normally there's a trend with the fish out here. You tend to catch them trolling south or east-west. It seems to be almost a daily trend. The current here predominantly is a north to south current, so you tend to catch more fish when you're trolling with the current. Plus it's easier on everybody in the boat too, because you're not fighting the waves all the time.
Stickfish.
Getter.
Right.
Is this your first salmon?
Yes.
You got a little king. There you go. Doing good.
Good job,
doing good.
It's almost legal.
What's the length limit on the king salmon?
On the Chinook, they have to be 24 inches or larger in the ocean. A coho, 12 inches or larger.
Okay, what's about the average weight of the fish you've been catching out here recently?
Most of the kings are in the mid-teens. We've even had fish upwards of 30, 35 pounds.
Wow.
The coho are running 5 to 6 pounds now, an occasional 10 pounder. The coho will get bigger over the next month or so.
There we go.
Hit it going down.
At least take him a little line.
That's a little better fish line.
That's a little bit.
Oh yeah.
This is your first salmon too?
Yeah.
Holy cow, we got two newbies.
Yeah, you
good
do.
Job. All right. You're doing good.
Perfect. That's a nice fish.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
That is a nice fish.
For first salmon, yeah.
When you look out there, you see the difference, the distance between the dorsal fin and the tail. Uh-huh. That'll tell you in a hurry that you know you got a nice fish.
I'm like, why is this fish so bad?
Yeah, we're okay.
Nice thing.
Oh my goodness.
Nice and easy.
Oh, nice fish.
Oh,
beautiful.
Oh
my goodness.
That's a nice fish.
I want mine.
Oh. Okay, now I want you to step back, Kevin. I'm going to help you.
Okay.
Yes! Hey!
Yeah!
Just a little bit of line.
Do you need to reel or?
Nope, you're good. You're
good. Good, just stand here.
Nice
oh my
fish.
Goodness.
Oh. How's that for a king?
Oh, that's
the
a
first
nice
fish ever.
Fish.
Oh, that
yeah,
deserves
baby
a hug. All right, good job.
Woohoo!
Nice fish.
I bet those charter people aren't catching a fish that looks like that.
That's a beaut.
That is gorgeous.
That's a beaut.
Oh yep, my goodness.
That's what keeps us coming out here.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Welcome back to Westport, Washington. I'm Justin Wolf. John Keizer is fishing today with his friend Kevin Lanier, also Benita Thompson, who's visiting from Florida, and my cousin Beth Featherstone, who's got the first keeper in the boat.
So what we have here is the Gold Star Hoochie, and we got it on, and we're gonna go ahead, send it back up again, put it back down. That was a nice fish. Since we're fishing this so deep, I also add just a little strip of herring to it. So I'll go ahead and add a little slice of herring to the hook setup, and we'll go ahead and run that down. And that one actually hit. I was letting it down, and he grabbed it about 70 feet and popped it off, and he was on his way immediately. So he just freight trained it. I got him hooked up here. And what I'm going to do is go ahead and just bleed him out. He'll be a lot better eating. Grab it on this side. Okay, we'll just put him down in the water for about 5 minutes here, let him bleed out, then we'll put him on ice. He'll be really good.
Oh yeah.
Later, Benita.
Yep. There you go. That one was like 210 feet. Oh no, actually it was 180. I moved it up. What do we got?
Little one. I didn't want to catch bait. That one wasn't legal yeah either.
Oh no, they gotta be a little bigger. Well, we want bigger fish in it anyway, so.
That's right.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
You ready? Felt a little better.
Hey John, how deep was that one?
It was 210 feet on the wire.
Wow.
Yeah.
There's been a lot of shrimp down there too.
Yeah, they're definitely, kings seem to be hanging towards that bottom area.
Oh, he came off.
Oh, no, 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 here, real, real.
Oh, I thought he came off.
Oh, no, not another one.
Hush.
So you're supposed to catch these next year.
Okay.
Come on.
Oh, yeah, that's a good fish. That's a good fish. That's a good fish. Yes, should be a good one. There he comes.
Oh, are you kidding me? God, it felt good.
I would have bet money that was at least
oh, yeah,
a 10, 15 pound
yep
fish. So I've been wanting to try one of these scent chambers for a while. And my good buddy here, Justin, brought one along. So I'm going to go ahead and tie one in here on the line, put it in just above the flasher, and give it a shot. So, all right, so we got some Angler West Scent Chamber Magic, new product. We're gonna go ahead and fill this thing up. And there she is, ready to go down. So on the squid, I'm gonna go ahead and put a little bit of sardine super gel. This stuff's great, sticks in there really good. So I'll go ahead and fill up the head, put a little bit on there, gives it plenty of scent. All right, and they're ready to fish.
There we go.
All right, here he is. Come on. All right. There we go.
All right, one more time.
All right, let's keep it.
All right. She's on.
Oh, yeah.
That one feel a little bigger?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Looks like, oh, yeah, that's a good fish.
Oh, double.
Again.
Save. All right. Woohoo! Double!
Deep doubles.
All right.
All right, nice fish.
Okay, come on to the back. You can brace yourself right against it.
There you go.
Keep reeling.
Looks like you got a little one.
Okay, bring him right over here. Benita's got a good one. The other one was a shake.
Okay.
So, but that's kind of the way it's been. It's been one good one, a couple shakers. All right, if he wants to go that way, just follow him around. Well, that's a good one.
Oh, yeah, nice.
That's a good fish. Okay, let me get in front of you. And I can take him.
All right.
Woohoo!
Good
job. Yeah. Woohoo! Woohoo! Finally!
Fine.
Nice. Nice job.
Woohoo!
There we go.
We're fishing out of Westport, Washington after a restful night at the Westport Inn, which is right next to the harbor where the Salt Patrol boat is moored all summer. So far, my cousin Beth has her first salmon ever, followed up by Bonita with her first keeper salmon ever. And we're getting them deep because that's where the bait is.
Here you go.
That one was at 225 feet, so 210 and 225 seem to be the magic depth right now.
Okay. I don't know if that was a scent chamber, but 2 minutes and we had a fish on it. Not even 2 minutes. Basically, put it back in the rod holder, turned around, we had a fish on it, so we're going to give it a little bit more.
All right, let's see what happens.
Okay, this time I put it on the squid, too.
All right, let's get another one.
So if you look here, what we're seeing here is that's a downrigger ball we just dropped down. Actually, that's a fish. Down here is a bunch of shrimp off the bottom. And how do we know that? Because Kevin opened one up and looked at it, and they were full of little shrimp. And then up here, if we zoom in, you can see there's a bait ball at the top here. And look at the fish swimming around. Here's the bait dropped on the surface, and there's fish sitting right in here. Those are all fish marks right there. So we got fish top and the bottom. Hopefully, we'll get something going here in a second.
We were out last Saturday and we were catching fish 190 feet or lower, and the kings were full of the salad size, or you know, bay shrimp,
yeah.
And just gorged with them. It was amazing they were even still eating.
So after we bleed the fish, we go ahead, we like to put them in the Yeti, a couple bags of ice. It's a really well-constructed cooler. It doesn't move around, has non-skids on the bottom of it, and it keeps the ice a long time, so I can get by for a few days with a couple bags of ice. The way you really want it for your ice to last long in a Yeti is you go ahead and shut it, latch it down. Okay, so then I have ice in here with water. Now I'll just go ahead and crack this a little bit, get a little water running out of it. Now I just vented the air out, and it creates this, it pulls this top down really tight and sucks it against that gasket. Creates that vacuum effect in there. Now my ice is sealed in there, and the cooler itself is really well built, so my ice will last a long time, so I can get by several days with a couple bags of ice.
Let's drop it on him once, see if he hits it. Hey man, just let me drop the balls and I'll put it back in gear.
I mean, if you get a fish, just nip it like that. You slow down, speed up, or drop the ball down, and they'll come back up and hit it.
Got a shaker on. There it goes.
There it goes.
Can't tell how many of them shakers I've done that to. It turned out to be big fish.
All right, ladies.
There you go. There you go.
Come on,
man. You all right?
Yep.
Let me know if you start getting bigger.
Okay.
All right, so what we've been doing is running a lot of whole herring out here.
It's makes a really good bait. The green's been a good color. So what I like is the Procure brine and bite. All I do is pour this in the bag, put the herring in it, and keep it cold. Let it go overnight. You got one on, Kevin?
I got doubles, one right here.
Double.
Doubles.
Okay.
Nita, let me get in here in front of you.
Okay.
Yeah, kiddo, you're doing good. Watch your fish.
Got it. That was a native coho, and right now the regulations say you can only keep a hatchery coho, so we have to let them go, and that's why we use barbless hooks and use a stick like this and pop the hook right out of its mouth, and they swim away safely.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good one. Okay, we're gonna trade spots.
Okay.
That one's gonna be legal.
Got it?
Yep.
Hey everybody, I hope you're enjoying today's show. Now before we go back to Westport, I'd like to talk to you a little bit about rod handles for salmon fishing. Now Lemongrass makes lots of great salmon rods, and many of them are available with either a cork handle or a composite graphite handle. Now cork is great, but it tends to deteriorate over the years, plus it's very difficult to keep clean. Now the graphite composite, on the other hand, will last virtually forever, and plus with just a quick shot of some good fisherman soap and wipe down with a rag, you can keep your rod looking brand new and scentless year after year. I don't think it's a good idea to have scents from weeks or months or years in the past on your rod and on your hands when you're handling your bait. So I like to keep my rod handles really clean, and this fisherman's scentless soap is a great way to do that. Now, this rod handle, besides being able to keep it clean, it will also slide in and out of the rod holders a lot easier than cork does. And if you're catching a lot of fish, or you're catching really big fish, that's a big deal. And it's also the handle that I chose for my new three-piece Angler West travel rod. So I think it's the right handle for a rod that's going to be a good friend and a workhorse for you year after year. Now, if you have questions about what's the right rod handle for you or the right rod for you, don't hesitate to contact Lemongrass. They'll answer all your questions. Now, let's go back to Westport and catch some more salmon. Welcome back to Westport on the Central Washington coast. I'm Justin Wolf. John Keizer, Kevin Lanier, Beth Featherstone, and Bonita Thompson are having a great day. But now...
Secret weapon.
Bonita...
I don't get rules about stuff like that.
...is thinking that her day is about to get even better.
Yep. Yeah?
Yep. Fish on!
That's a fish.
That's the one you want.
That's the one we've been looking for. That's the one we've been
we
looking for.
We have a fighter.
Woo! Yes. Oh, nice fish. Yeah.
There you go. Gaining on?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Little bit.
That's a good fish. That's another one. 230 feet. Flasher and squid. No pressure.
No pressure.
No pressure. No pressure.
Pay $100 for a barb on that hook.
Oh, all you gotta do is keep tight line on him.
Yeah, just tight line.
Tight line and smooth, that's all you gotta be.
He's helping you with the boat too.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that's okay. Let's keep him coming.
Fish.
That's a nice one.
Oh, look at that. Look at that back.
One more pull.
There you go.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. Good job.
Yes.
Yeah.
Got him.
Nice job. Now watch
Yay.
This.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
There we go.
Gorgeous.
Oh, that's a pretty
nice
fish.
Fish.
So out here in the ocean, in Area 2, Westport, the coastal area, party fishing's allowed. So there's, five of us on the boat, and so we're allowed to keep, two fish each. So, of course, we're making the girls do all the work.
Nice fish.
That's just a good fish.
Okay, so it gets a little closer. We're going to have you step back.
Okay.
And Kevin's going to help you. We're going to lift the rod tip up.
Okay.
And
nice fish.
Yeah, that's a nice fish, that's why. Give me a head raise.
All right, in the net.
Woohoo! Wake up, Burra.
Another one. Just put it down to 230 on the Scotty and bang, away it went. It was like instantaneous. And yeah, just turned around and it went off.
Double.
Get after him.
Fish on.
Get after him,
Kim. Come on, Beth.
I'm up here.
Well, there's a nice fish out there. Okay, keep the tension.
Now it's got a fin.
Hey, in the net. Score.
Look at that. Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.